Today I will take for third semester this new course of professional development. This course is designed on place of the professional activity. So in this particular course we have to learn, the learning contents are there: team leaders, importance of team leader, role of team leaders, important qualities of good team leaders, and behaviors of good team leaders. These are the points which are to be discussed on this particular topic. So I just start. First of all, we will discuss what is the meaning of team. Team means T-E-M. Full form of team is together each achieve more, means when together each people work, then they achieve more. So together each achieve more, this is the meaning of team. Together each achieve more, this is the meaning of team. A team is consist of a group of persons or maybe number of persons in a group. So that group of person cannot work until unless there is a guide for them is not available. So this is together each achieved more. This is the meaning of team. And leader is a person who coordinate and organize a group of peoples for instruct them, to achieve a common goal decided by the organization, So what is the definition of a leader? It is a person who coordinate and organize a group of peoples for instruct them to achieve a common goal decided by the organization. So team and leader. So this is the team. Team leader. Team leader, the definition I have given, team, that is together each achieved more. This is the meaning of team. Leader is a person who cooperate, coordinate and organize a group of peoples for instruct them to achieve a common goal decided by the organization. There is a difference between political leader and leaders who are working in the industry. Political leaders have very vast field of application. They are coming in contact with general public, so their property, their qualities are different from the what the persons who are giving leadership in the industry. In industry, what happen? There are group of persons who are working in the industries, and a leader lead in terms of achieving the target of the industry, whatever target given by the management. So leadership quality is a very important quality. It's to be developed in the diploma engineers and degree engineers. This particular quality, it is a totally professional quality in which persons have the ability to cooperate, coordinate and organize. Now, apart from this, the duty of leader is different, that one is planning of work, second is organizing of work, third is staffing of work for work, then directing for the work, then coordination of work, coordination of work, then representation of work. Whatever you are doing, it is to be represented, representation of work, representation of work, and third is budgeting for whole activity, budgeting for whole activity. So these are the different organizational activities which is to be performed by a leader. So leader perform what are the activities? Planning of the work, then organize the manpower for the work, then allotment of different work to different peoples, then he has to give the direction to the peoples for work, then coordinate the work so that activity at different work point, they are run smoothly. So this is the main work of the leader. Then whatever work he perform with the help of team, it is to be represented to the higher management. So there is a representation part is also there. It is to be done by the leader. Then for whole work to be performed, there is a requirement of some budget for the activities. So leader should also look after the budgeting process of the total work. So here the leadership quality, it is given by these planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordination, representation and budgeting. These are the quality of a leader. Now the next article he has given, that importance of team leader. Importance of team leader is given that team leader is a main key person for organize or performance of any activity in the organization. There are group of persons may be decided according to the volume of work. There may be 25 persons in a group. There may be 50 persons in a group. There may be 100 people may be there in a group. So leader have importance to understand the difficulties, problems of the group persons and try to solve their problem. And whatever target given by the management, it is to be achieved with the help of this group of persons. So whenever importance point of a leader is there, the leader should have definite some specific qualities than the other persons. So these qualities given according to these activities to be performed. The first important quality of a leader, that he should be a good personality person. His personality, physical personality should be good, so that command for the persons to whom he was want to control, that command is given properly if personality of leader is good. Then definitely first impression is there by the personality of the leader. Second is his behavior, how he behave. His behavior should be good with all the peoples who are working under him, and according to those behavior he can take the work from any type of person. Normally in a group of person there are three types of persons are there. One person, they are not working. Even after giving number of instructions, number of warnings, the peoples are not performing work. Second persons are there who are given with certain instruction, they start work. And third quality of workers, they are self-motivated. Without any instruction, they start their work. So these three quality of workers to be controlled by the leader. So leader first have to give more stress or more importance to those workers who are generally of first category. That is those who are not working even given number of instruction, number of warning to them. So necessary action should be taken by the team leader to convert these peoples in the second category. Second category workers are those which work by instructions and they are having sufficient activity or having an approach for work. So whenever leader pass the instruction, so they start work. And third category is the best category, that is without any instruction, but by just knowing what they have to do or what is their target of work for a particular day, they start working. So in these three category of workers, the leadership is very important. Leader has to give more stress on first and second category. The third category of worker, they are doing work without any much efforts by the leader. So leader should have the quality that importance of the leader is due to all these points, and importance of leader to the management, it is very essential. Leader is a chain or medium between group of person and management. Leader is a chain between top management and the peoples working in the industry. So इट इज़ ए वर्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन, दिस इज वर्टिकल डाउन कम्युनिकेशन व्हेन लीडर स्पीक टू वर्कर्स, एंड इट इज़ वर्टिकल अप कम्युनिकेशन व्हेन लीडर स्पीक टू मैनेजमेंट. सो डेफिनेटली दिस लिंक बिटवीन मैनेजमेंट एंड वर्कर्स, दिस इज द लीडर. लीडरशिप क्वालिटी, सम पीपल्स हैविंग इनहेरेंट क्वालिटी ऑफ लीडरशिप एंड सम पीपल्स लर्न द लीडरशिप बाय डूइंग द वर्क. यू पीपल्स एज अ स्टूडेंट नॉट नो द बेसिक ऑफ द लीडरशिप, दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव टू बी पर्टिकुलरली लर्न दीज क्वालिटीज बाय एक्चुअल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ लीडरशिप इन अ ग्रुप. Now, according to your content of syllabus, we have to perform some practicals on this leadership quality. So, for this purpose, it is necessary that students should present in the institute. But today, or for the forthcoming some 2-3 months, it is not possible that all students will come to college. So practical aspect of this will be taken only when the student present in the department or the class, they will be form a particular group of suppose you are 60 student in second year, so we will form 15 persons one group, so there will be 4 groups will be there, and we select one leader to control that group, and we will give the different task to different groups and give a definite time to them to complete that particular task. So leadership quality we will judge by the practical experiment. Theoretically I can give the number of things, number of property, number of qualities, everything, but what happen until unless you practically perform it, you cannot understand. Suppose you want to organize a program in the institute itself, then what you have done in your annual function, at the time of that refreshment stall you have organized, so in which all the 3 years student of electrical, they combine together and they given a task to particular stall to be prepared for refreshment. So that was a activity, but in which I have observed that there are certain students, they are involved 100% in that activity. There were different activities was there, but every student not include in every activity. There was a small groups they have formed, that some people arrange for the decoration, some people arrange for the breakfast or whatever food material, some people are engaged in electricity supply taking, some people are engaged for welcome of the guest. So these all activities, 4-5 activities was there at that time, but I have seen that all students, they are divided according to their choice, the work was there, it is done by them. In that particular case, we have not taken any indication of a particular leadership in that particular program. Leadership is one in which particular person is one who is leader, and he will organize whole program or whole activities according to the planning. So that particular work done by you in your social gathering, in annual function, that was a individual activity taken by the responsibility of individual student, and they were performed them. They were given a target, and that target was common, and this was spread to all the students that what they have to do. So according to they have successfully done that particular work and got prize on that also. So my question is that when we talk about this leadership of the person who has to take work from the others in the industry, then it is necessary that he should have the number of qualities. So these number of qualities we will discuss later on. For today, the introductory part of this particular lecture I have taken, in which team leaders, what is the meaning of team, what is the team leader, what is the importance of team leader. Now other information regarding this particular syllabus I am giving to you. The name of this course is Professional Development 3. 3 means you are in third semester, that's why it is written Professional Development 3. This professional development will also come in fourth semester, also come in fifth semester, also come in sixth semester. But in every semester, the content of the syllabus will be different. In this particular content of development 3, it is only concentrate on the learning of leadership. So we will total number of period he has given, 8 periods in which we have to complete these activities. Of course, the content of this syllabus is not much more that can be completed in teaching hours. Total he has given 7, and the practical hours he has given 13. The code number of this particular course is 305, and according to that this subject will be learned. The most of the part he has given, the teachers will organize a student team event in class or department. Few students will ask to play roles of team members and the leaders to solve the problems under given situation. This is the practical part of this particular syllabus. Otherwise, in theoretical part, today I have discussed team leaders, definition of team, then definition of leader, then importance of team leader. Now role of team leader is next, then importance, quality of good team leader. These two, three article I will discuss next time. So for today, it is an introductory part of this particular syllabus, which is a very short syllabus, but it is practical oriented, in which we have to perform the activities of the group by just forming the group of students and selecting one leader for each group, and they will be given with a task. The task may be a technical task, or it may be a social task, it may be institute related task. So whatever task will be given, how a student will manage for this and how he can organize that particular task. In task management, you just understand simply what the leader has to do. First planning, then organize the workers or the students under him, then allotment of duties to each worker, that will be staffing, then give the direction for what to do, that the direction, and after giving direction, he has to coordinate the number of students who has given different work. Then student have to represent whatever work they have done, so the representation part is there. And for all activities, definitely for every work, money is required. So it is the duty of that particular leader, he should also budget, prepare a budget for all activities, and according to that he should perform. So what is the base quality of a leader? That he should have cooperation and coordination. He should understand the problem of the individual person of the group, and he should take care of everyone, and he should be foresight net should be there in the leadership, so that he can understand the problem which may come in future. So this task for any activity, it is not a one day task. This may take 2 days, 3 days, 1 week, 1 month even. So during that period, how leader will work, that all qualities are given here. And I have given the definition of team as well as of leader. there are so many person giving so many different definition of leader, but a simple definition I have given is a person who cooperate, coordinate and organize a group of people for instruct them to achieve a common goal decided by the organization. Means leader is given work from the top management and he has to fulfill that work with the help of number of people. Here one thing is to be noted that a good leader, he should work within available resources. Many times what happens, there is a shortage of resources, we have to perform the work. So it is the duty of that leader how he should perform that particular type of work within available resources. In defense services, this can be seen by many film which are prepared or made by the different directors on war film. In war film, you see the leadership of a military person or captain or brigadier or other post persons, that how they have organized in a crisis period to lead the group. So leader have responsibility to first sacrifice and after that he should do